for you.
Governor Newsom is apologizing to Native Americans on California's behalf for violence and mistreatment inflicted on indigenous people in the past. The governor met with tribal leaders yesterday and announced the formation of a new commission called the Truth and Healing Council. That council will allow Native Americans to clarify the historical record of the state's violence against them. For more on the governor's executive order, we are joined now live by California Assembly member James Ramos, who was the first California Native American elected to our state's legislature. Assemblyman Ramos, we appreciate you coming on today. How significant of a step is this?
This is a real significant step. For the first time in California's history, we have a sitting governor recognizing the atrocities and basically genocide and extermination policies against the California Indian people. This is significant because now it would allow lawmakers such as myself to start to push legislation that recognizes those areas and also starts to bring the true history of the state of California and its treatment towards California's first people to the forefront of issues.
What do you think this apology means to California's Native American community? I mean, I imagine you've been speaking with some of your constituents. What does this mean to them?
It means a lot. I mean, so for years in my own area, I grew up on the San Manuel Indian Reservation. And in our area in 1866, there was a 32-day battle that took place. And really, a militia was formed in the San Bernardino Valley to go into the San Bernardino Mountains and rid the mountains of all Indian people there. And it was there that our clan, the Yohaviantem clan of the Suwanee people, dwindled to less than 30 members. And so that way of life changed. And for years, we would talk about that in schools and talk about that with community members. But yet some didn't truly believe that those atrocities happened here in the state of California, where in history books and books that were being taught in the school system, we're talking about tribes which have a lot of history there, but the Trail of Tears that took place in other parts of the United States. But we're talking about history towards California Indian people, where extermination policies were taken out, where militias were formed and paid by the state to go out there and rid the mountains of Indian people. And so this moving forward starts to now have this from the top administration, from the governor, to acknowledge those atrocities that happened, validates and really continues to move forward. And speaking on behalf of the Indian people, it has come at a time to where now we can start to move forward and begin the healing process.
So, I mean, obviously, you know, an apology like this, a formal apology is one thing, but you obviously must be looking for, you want to see action moving forward. You know, what do you hope will be done from, you know, from the state's perspective to improve the lives of California's Native American community?
So looking at the issues that are facing California Indian people, there's fairly recognized tribes in the state of California. However, there's also California Indian people that during the history of the state of California have been left out of the discussion. Those tribal people, ancestral territories from throughout the state of California, Los Angeles, San Francisco, that's ancestral territory of Indian people. And it's time that we get that history starting to be taught in the local school systems. One thing that continues to be a debate is the missionary system. When we talk about the missionaries in the state of California, but yet now with this executive order, we're going to be able to tell the perspective from the Indian perspective on what happened and how Indian people were taken into those missions to basically be the indentured slavery to build those missions and what happened during that time.
Do you think this should, you know, this formal apology from the governor, is it your hope that this might lead to the state committing more money to help Native American communities here in California, many of which, you know, are struggling with poverty and other issues?
I believe now with this executive order moving forward brings all that into the forefront of being able to look at public safety on Indian reservations, educational attainment. And one that's really a big area that's out there is missing and murdered indigenous women in the state of California. missing and murdered indigenous women and those cases going unsolved starts to bring those discussions to the forefront and to the level that needs to be heard at the governor's level, the attorney general's level, and being able to have the state legislature move forward on resolutions and bills that start to bring into account those areas that are important to the Indian people.
Do you think it took too long for this formal apology from the state of California to come?
Well, I think a lot of things have a way of working themselves forward. Certainly in 2018, I became the first California Indian ever elected to the state legislature. And some say, well, that's a great accomplishment. But one would ask, why did it take so long? And the governor, this governor, moving forward on his own to bring forward an apology on this, from the state of California, starts to show where we're at within our diversity, where we're at with the acceptance of culture, and where we're at telling the truth of history of the state of California. So some will say it took too long to get to this point, but this governor moved forward on it. So now the question should be, where will we be in the next few months? Where will we be in the next year? Where will we be in the next 5 years to make sure that this topic does not go back and be forgotten about?
Okay, well, we have to leave the conversation there. I really appreciate your time. That's Assemblyman James Ramos from Southern California.